One week from tomorrow, Muslims will gather at the state capitol. Extremist groups like ISIS or ISIL, whatever term you prefer, have unfortunately shoved all Muslims into the spotlight. It is for that reason, tonight, we start a conversation, one centered on misconceptions about Muslims and Islam.
We are doctors, we are engineers, we are professors, we are contributing community. I'm a delegate, GOP delegate.
Muhammad Huck runs the Muslim Community Center in Bloomington. He says sometimes their contributions are overshadowed, and too often, he believes Muslims are accused of ties to terrorism.
We are 1.6 billion Muslims in the world. Not 1.6 billion are terrorists. There's a lot of goodness in this world, a lot of goodness. There are some wackos, there are some extremes, yes. But there are a lot of good people.
Huck speaks with passion about the misconceptions linked to Muslims and their faith, Islam.
I mean, unless you come and ask me or say, I mean, who I am, what we believe in, how are we going to dispel this myth, Islamophobia? This is a new word, and there's a new trend.
Is it real?
It is, because we have some of our community members are a victim, have fallen a victim to that.
If you were to describe Islam in a few sentences, what would you say?
Islam is submission to the will of God. So anyone who submits to the will of God is a Muslim. And that faith that you're, I mean, you're trying to be a good Muslim, good person, I mean, if you're trying to submit, God has told us to do good things. You know, do charity, be nice to people, be nice to the neighbors, be nice to humanity.
Muslims are the fastest growing religious group in the world, according to Pew Research Center.
To the Muslims, the Quran is what the Bible is to Christians.
Yes.
Jihad, a word that appears frequently in the Quran, he says is another misconception of Islam.
Jihad means it is a struggle to live a good life, to improve your quality of life. And it is a struggle to do an honest thing. For example, if I'm working two jobs, to make a living, to make ends meet, that's a struggle.
Sweets could be for me, yes, that's my jihad.
If you are trying to resist eating sweets, yes, that's your jihad. You're struggling to keep your quality of life up. That's jihad.
Huck has support from neighboring Christians and community members. This one from Lutherans in the suburbs says, "We will stand by you in peace and love." Another showing gratitude for the value you add to our community.
We need to dispel the myth that we are terrorists, we are this, we are that. But eventually, things will, hope, I pray, that things will improve and improve for good.
So our conversation took place on a Friday night. Friday, guys. It lasted about 90 minutes. And he talked about misconceptions related to Muslim women. And he also talked a lot about the Quran. And he said the Quran teachings allow Muslims to defend themselves. But he says, if, let's say, you're trying to kill me, Jana, if I were Muslim, I could defend myself. But that is the only type of aggression, he says, the Quran allows.
Which is the exact same thing that happens in, if one believes in the Bible and Christianity, an eye for an eye idea. Mm-hmm. In the United States, we have the death penalty. No real difference there.
Yeah, I just think there's a lot of misinformation, and I think we all can learn more by just studying these sorts of things. And I remember listening to this radio program last week where they were talking about these misconceptions about the religion, and I learned a great deal just listening to that program. Yeah. They were saying how the Prophet Muhammad's, one of his wives was Christian, right? So there's a lot we can all learn, and appreciate you doing that story.
Hopefully we can do more.
Yes, absolutely.